Hey guys, Mark here. I hope you are well. Today I'm going to show you an interesting paracord keyfob design. This one is a bit of work to do, but the result is, in my opinion, very much worth it. Here you can see a couple of examples of this style of a keyfob. The larger one is made using Paracord 550. The smaller one is made using Type 1 Paracord. Let's take a look at the techniques used to make this key fob. At the top, we have a loop. The loop is made by twisting two strands together. Then, we have a foot rope knot, crown knots, a diamond knot, a star knot, and at the bottom, a double crown knot. And that's our project. Let's take a look at the supplies, then get to tying. As far as supplies go, you're going to need 3 pieces of paracord, each 5 feet long. For the core of the key fob, you're going to need a stick, a piece of wire, a nail, something like that. In my case, the length of this stick is a bit under 3 inches. For finishing your project, a lacing needle comes in handy. Finally, scissors and a lighter are going to be used to cut and melt your paracord. So, let's begin. We are going to start our project off by forming the loop. Take 2 pieces of paracord. Fold the 2 pieces in half. So let's say that this is the middle point. Move up about an inch and place your 2 cords under a heavy object. Then twist the 2 cords into one. Take the left end, twist it away from you, and place it over the right end. Take the new left end, twist it away from you, and place it over the right end. And again, left end, twist it, place it over. Left end, twist it, place it over. Left end, twist, place over. We're going to do this until we get a sufficient length for our loop. At that point, we're going to take our 4 ends and bring them together. This forms our loop. I now have a loop and 4 ends. I tied the loop together to make tying a bit easier. Spread apart your ends, one to each side, like this. Take an additional piece of paracord and place it among your ends. Then tie a crown knot. Take an end, pass it counterclockwise over the next end. The next end passes counterclockwise over the next end, and the next end counterclockwise over the next end. and the next tent. Counterclockwise over the next tent. And the next tent. Counterclockwise over the last of our ends. The last tent passes into the loop created by the first tent. So simply pass into it. Tighten up, and what you're going to get is a 6-stranded crown knot. So it should have a hexagon shape. Like this. Take an end, it doesn't matter where you start. Pass over the next strand and immediately up through the center of the knot. So like this. And the next end over the next strand and through the center. And the next end over and through the center. And the next end over the next strand and through the center. And the next end over the next strand and through the center. And the last of our ends over and through the center. So this ties the foot rope knot. Now gently pull on the ends to tighten it up. So this is how it looks like. Try to tighten it up as close to the loop as possible. When you're happy with your foot rope knot, it's time to continue. We are now going to continue by tying a series of crown knots. To start off, spread apart your ends. So something like this. Take one of the ends and pass it counterclockwise over the next end. Then, the next end passes counterclockwise over the next end. And the next end counterclockwise over the next end. And the next end counterclockwise over the next end. And the next end over the last of our ends. And the last of our ends passes into the loop created by the first end. Tighten up. like this. Now insert a stick or any other type of a chord. Then simply continue with your crown notes. So like this and tighten up. So like this. The goal here is to stack a bunch of crown notes to cover the chord. So this should be the end result. After a series of crown notes, we're going to continue by tying a diamond knot. The diamond knot is started with a wall knot. The wall knot is similar to the crown knot, but instead of going over your next strand, we pass under it. So, with one of your strands, pass counterclockwise under the next strand. The next strand passes under the next strand. Then the next strand passes under the next strand. And the next one under the next one. And the next one under our final strand. And the final one passes under and through the loop created by our first strand. Tighten up, and what you have is a wall knot. To tie the diamond knot, now pick up any of the ends and pass over under. So over one of the strands and under the second one, like this. Grab the end to keep it out of the way. Pick up the next end and repeat. Over, under, and grab it out of the way. And the next end, over, under, so over under, and grab it out of the way. And the next end, over, under, and grab it out of the way. And the next end, over under, like this. And the next and final end, over and under. So this is how the diamond knot should look like. Each of the ends should be coming out after one of the strands coming out of the crown knot. We are now going to double up the diamond knot. Pick up a strand and double up this strand next to it. We're going to double it up on the inner side. So pass over the strand like this. Then start following it, traveling under like this. And under again here. And under here at the top. Like this. Then simply take the next strand, so let's say this one, and again double up this strand by passing over it and doubling it up on the inner side. So like this. Under here. And under here at the top. Then simply take the next strand and repeat. So double up this strand, passing over it, then traveling under these two strands. Under here. And under here. And we're going to do this with the rest of our ends as well. So pick up the next one, pass over the next strand that you're going to double up, pass under these two strands, under here, and under these two strands, then I'm going to take one of these two ends. Since I'm doubling up on the inner side, I'm going to take the outer of the two. So the outer one passes over this strand and doubles it up. Then, the next pair, again, take the outer of the two ends and double up the strand. So pass over it and double it up on the inner side, like this. So, check that all of your strands are doubled up. If they are, you have a double diamond knot. To tighten it up a bit, start with the strands coming out of the crown knot and work them through the knot. And pull the slack into the ends. So at some point you're going to be happy with the look of your diamond knot. Then we're going to continue. We are now going to tie a star knot. To start off, spread apart your ends. Take an end and twist it into a loop. Take the next end in the counterclockwise direction, twist it into a loop, and feed the end through your first loop, bottom up. Take the next end, and again twist it into a loop, and feed it through the previous loop, bottom up. Take the next end, twist it into a loop, and feed the end through the previous loop. Take the next end, twist it into a loop, and feed it through the previous loop. Take the last remaining end, twist it, and feed it into the previous loop. Take the first end, so the end of your first strand, and feed it into your last loop. Tighten up a little bit. Like this. Then tie a crown knot. Take a strand, pass it counterclockwise over the next end. Take the next end, pass it counterclockwise over the next end. Take the next end, counterclockwise over the next end. And the next end over the next. And the next over the next. The final end passes into the loop created by the first strand. Then tighten up your crown knot. Like this. Now we're going to double up our star knot. Take a strand and follow the next strand in the clockwise direction. So to do this, double up this loop below by going above it, creating a second loop. Then, passing alongside the next end, under and into the loop. Like this. Take the next end and again double up the bottom loop and pass alongside this strand. Take the next end, again double up the loop below and pass alongside the next end. And the next end again doubles up the loop below and passes alongside the next end. And the next end travels alongside the next end and into the two loops on the other side. And our final end again passes alongside one of the ends, so the last one that is left undoubled and into the two loops. So now we have tied the top side of the star knot. Turn it around. And we're going to finish up the bottom. tekenend and feeded past a strand coming out of the diamond knot, so past it and through the center of the star knot. This way we double up this section. Take the next strand, pass over the next strand coming out of the diamond knot and through the center of the star knot. And the next strand over the strand coming out of the diamond knot and through the center of the star knot. And the next end over the strand coming out of the diamond knot and through the center of the star knot. And the next end over this strand and through the center of the star knot. And the last remaining strand, past a strand coming out of the diamond knot and through the center of the star knot. So at this point we should have 6 ends coming out through the star knot. Now we're going to tighten up the star knot a little bit. This is done by starting at a strand coming out of the diamond knot. Pull on it and remove the slack by working it through your star knot. Then pull it into one of the ends. Then simply continue with the next strand coming out of the diamond knot. So something like this. We are now going to finish up our project by first tying a crown knot and then doubling it up. Take a strand, pass it counterclockwise over the next strand. The next strand passes counterclockwise over the next strand, and the next one over the next, and the next one over the next, and the next one over the next, and the final one into the loop created by the first strand. Then tighten up. So like this. Now we're going to take a lacing needle and begin doubling up the crown knot. Pick up a strand . Follow this strand in the crown knot, so double it up and move your end to the bottom of the star knot, like this. Take the next end, So double up this strand and move the end to the bottom of the star knot. Like this. Then the next end doubles up a strand in the crown knot and moves to the bottom of the star knot. And the next end again doubles up an end in the crown knot like this. And the next end doubles up a strand in the crown knot and the last of your strands doubles up a strand, the last remaining free one in the crown knot. So again, simply work your end to the bottom of the star knot. And this is the double crown knot. Very carefully tighten it up. We are now going to finish up our project by trimming the ends. Try to cut them as close to your project as possible. Then, very lightly melt the ends a little bit. Be careful not to burn any of the surrounding cords. Finally, take your lacing needle and push the ends out of sight. And that's our project. Guys, I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that I made things clear enough. Thank you for joining me and see you next time.